Welcome to another video lecture. Today we will discuss about the analysis of frames using the consistent deformation method. I hope all of you have watched the previous video lectures. Okay, so please note down the question. So this is our frame having one end is fixed and the other end is roller support. The diameter is given as 3 meter at this point, and here one point load is acting here, 10 kN, and here one another 20 kN is acting at this point, and the moment of inertia is given here I, and here is also I, and here 2I. Okay, so please note down this question. Okay, so what is the first step? The same steps is, the steps is remain same in the case of continuous and other frames also. So first of all, we have to find out the determinancy, what is the value. So here number of reactions is 3, here 1, so total 4. So R minus 3 equals 4 minus 3 equals 1. Okay, so there is only one member is redundant. So for the easiness, we will consider this R D, joint D will be the redundant member, or reaction R D or V D or any points. Okay, so this point will be our redundant member. So remove that member. Then what is the next case? After removing, we have to find out what is the deflection occur at this point. After removing the redundant member, what is the deflection occur at this point due to 20 kN and 10 kN? Okay, which method we are using? Unit load method. Already we discussed about these things in our second module. Okay, so using unit load method, we can able to find out the deflection at here. Okay, for that we will consider each sections, first CD, then CF, then BF, then BE and AE. These are the different sections we are going to consider. So the origin will be, for the CD will be D, and CF will be C, and for FB F, and BE B, and EA E. The limits are also according to the length we will consider, 0 to 4 likewise. And also EA also will be, it is also given in the question. So coming to the moment, how to calculate the moment. So first of all, in this case there is no forces occur at this point D. So what is the moment at CD? There will be no moment at here. If you are going to consider any section, there is no moment since no force are here. So then coming to CF, if you are going to take a section, is there any moment here? No moment. Then coming to FB, what is going to happen? If you are going to consider a section here, X, if you are going to consider section X, what is going to happen? Only this 20 kN is acting here. So the value will be minus 20 into X. Similarly, coming to BE section, what is going to happen? This much moment is going to appear here. So minus 20 into 2. So minus 40 will be occurring here. Okay. We are only considering this 20 kN and this distance is 2. So the total moment will be minus 40. That is written here. Then what about EA? What about the value at EA? Already this minus 20 into 40, that moment will be there. Then minus 10 into X. Okay, hope it is clear. Then coming to the unit load, you are going to apply a 1 kN. You are going to apply 1 kN force here. Then what is the moment will appear here? So in the first case, if you are going to take a section, there is no moment. So that is 0. Then you are then going to come into CF portion. So this force will occur here also. If you are taking a section, then it will become minus X. Then coming to next portion here, there is no loads here, no external loads, only this 1 kN force is acting here. So then what is going to happen? If you are going to take a section here, minus x plus 2, that means how much distance? This distance is 2. So x plus 2 into minus 1. And this, how this minus 4 comes here? How this minus 4 comes here? Here 1 kilonewton is acting and the distance is 4. So the total moment will be here is minus 4. That is after here. Similarly, EA portion is also minus EA. Minus 4, sorry. Minus 4 is appearing here. So these are the tabular column for unit torque calculation. Then what about the deflection? This is the general equation, capital M multiplied by small m dx by EA. So if you integrate, you will finally get this value. Please do it. Okay. So this is our first step. Then what should we do? All steps are over. Whether the steps are over? Now you only consider about the external loads. When you apply that external loads, what's the deflection at the point D? That only you calculate. Then you have to take down the vertical reaction, that is redundant member. Then you have to consider the redundant member. When you are going to apply this BD, let us take the redundant member as BD. Then what is the forces occurring here? So here we can write down, when BD is applied, what is the downward deflection? And we can consider this is a general statement. Delta dash equals m dash m dx by a. This is a general statement. How this happens, I will show you. Okay. And here it is written that m dash equals bd into small m. Okay. So how this equation is going to happen, I will show you. So please consider this bd force acting here. Okay. You are going to consider this BD forces acting at this joint. No other external forces are here. Okay. So let us take a section. So in the first case, what is the value if you are going to take a section? There is no forces. So it will be 0. And if you are going to consider this portion, here you can recognize how this BD into small m comes. If you are going to consider this portion, then BD multiplied by x will be the moment. That means m dash. M dash equals BD multiplied by x. Then it is already written that m. It is already mentioned here. Small m is mentioned here. So you can obtain that if you are going to consider this section, the value will be minus BD into x. Minus BD into x. So the value of m is written as minus x. So we can directly write down as BD into m. This is a general statement, okay? Please listen carefully. This is a general statement, BD into smaller. Okay. So after calculating all these values, what's our next intention? You have to multiply with this unit load. Again, you have to apply this unit load. Again, you have to apply this unit load at the point where we have to find out the deflection. I hope it is clear also. How you are going to consider, this is the general statement. M dash equals Vd multiplied by small m. How? It is obtained already mentioned here. You have to apply as Vd over the joint. And what is the, if you are going to take a section, let us take this as an example. So BD multiplied by X will be the moment M dash. So it is written BD into M. I hope it is clear. Or let us take an example here. If you are going to consider this as a section X, then what will be the value? BD multiplied by the total distance. That means X plus 2. Since it is in the clockwise direction, it will be minus x plus 2. So again, you are going to get the same value. So again, this general equation satisfies. So if you solve, finally you will get this value. Okay, then what is our condition? At this point, what is the condition? If you are applying this external loads and this redundant member, the total deflection remains same. or it should be in equilibrium, isn't it? So equilibrium in the sense, if you are applying this external and external loads and you hear the redundant member, the deflection happened, there should be no deflection. So we can apply the equation, the consistency equation, delta dash plus delta equals to zero. It should remain same. So finally, after calculating, you will get the reaction speed E, V and MA. Okay. So this is the general statement. Delta dash plus delta equals zero. Since there should not be any displacement, or the total displacement remains constant, remains zero. There should be no displacement. Even if due to this external loads and the summation of this external loads and also the redundant number should be equal to zero. So finally you will get the value VD, PE and MA. I hope this lecture is also clear. If you didn't get, please watch once more. I hope it will convey. Okay, thank you.